So, were you all expecting me to do... Well, too bad. We're not doing Dino Crisis. Instead, we're doing Ghostbusters the video game, which happens to be my second favorite movie game. While it's not technically based off a movie, it is based off the movie franchise of Ghostbusters the game. So in other words, basically I just tricked y'all. Like trick or treat. Well, you're getting it. Well, you're being tricked because I'm not playing Dino Crisis. You're getting a treat of Ghostbusters the game. Anyway, let's catch some ghosts. Also, I like it how here that they're like saying, oh hey, be very careful, because you could have like a whole that seizure and all that kind of stuff. Also, look how many creators were working on this remaster. We got Saber, we got Mad Dog, of course, good old Sonny. Ghost Corps, a Columbia Pictures company. And of course, Thermo whatever. That's actually just kind of adorable how the way they did that. And I straight up forgot to mute my TV. Already, I tricked myself. So anyway, the first thing I should mention is, one, while I am playing this on the PS5, this is still, in the end, a PS4 game. So, yep. The second thing, why I would have done Ghostbusters the game on the PS3, I still have not collected my PS3 remote yet. Like a brand new one, because my old one, apparently PS3 controllers drift. Great. It'll probably be some time before I'll ever get another chance at doing a PS3 game. Also, the third reason is I don't see any point in doing multiplayer. And that's actually a feature that was in the PS3 and the Xbox 360 version. I don't know if the Wii... I think this game also came out on the DS. I kind of actually don't remember. Have multiplayer stuff in it. But, of course, future me, you know what to do. Anyway, before I even mention this now, I've actually already played through this game. Yeah, I love this game that much. So I thought to myself, okay, how about I do Ghostbusters the game? A beloved video game franchise. I mean, a beloved movie franchise, TV show franchise, comic, like anything. Like this, you can find Ghostbusters stuff just about anywhere. Kind of similar to Godzilla and Kong. Anyway, I'm going to shut up and let y'all listen to incredibly good music.
Are you troubled by strange noises in the night?
Do you experience feelings of dread in your basement or attic?
Have you or your family actually seen a spook, specter, or ghost?
If the answer is yes, then don't wait another minute.
Just pick up the phone and call the professionals.
Call the Ghostbusters. We're ready to believe you.
Franchises available soon.
Call for details.
Whoa! Russell! Hey, man!
You near the East Wing?
Yep.
By the new Ghoster exhibit?
Yeah, why?
There's something headed your way.
Wait. I hear something. I'm gonna take a look.
Wanna hear something really creepy? I was reading about Shandor, you know, the guy who donated most of the Gozer stuff. He was into the occult, you know, supernatural. Weird dude.
Why don't we talk about it some other time? Any other time.
Hey, you can't be in here. Stop!
Ghostbusters, is your haunting an apparition, poltergeist, phantasm, wraith, banshee, demon, spectre, tortured soul? What? No, we do not summon dead family members and catch them so you can ask the combination to the safe. Yeah, well, same to you, pal.
Hey, it's the new cadet. Welcome aboard.
This might be a little dangerous.
Great. Danger is our life.
We'll start at 50% capacity. That should keep any burning or tissue damage to a minimum.
Hey, if you're gonna burn any tissue, do it to the new kid. You can't use Ray. Our mortgage is in his name.
I guess he's right. What's your name again, kid?
No names, Ray. I don't want to get too attached to this kid. You know, just in case. You remember what happened to the last guy.
He's tuned and ready to go.
You may feel a little tingle. Good. We've perfected an extensive and rigorous training regimen that will teach you all your equipment's basic functions.
It takes some time to achieve master throw skill, but it's definitely worth the effort.
Was that us?
I don't think so.
Ray?
Had to be some sort of psi energy pulse. Substantial. A significant collected and centralized necromantic convulsion, level 7 or more.
Agreed. We need EMF measurement checks now.
I know the answer, but I'm gonna ask anyway. Is a level 7, whatever, bad or very bad?
On a scale of 1 to 10, I would say...
Let me guess. It's a 7.
Let's just say we're about to get real busy.
And that is not the fun kind of getting busy, is it, Ray?
Look out! Slimer's escaped again!
No, wait, come back.
So, as you kind of saw earlier during the opening of the Ghostbusters opening, that the other reason why I chose to let's play this is because in the newer version, they gave off their condolences to Arnold, I mean not Arnold, to Harold Ramis, a legend, a really good man, funny as heck. Rest in peace, Harold Ramis, you will be missed. And yes, I did saw Ghostbusters Afterlife. It was really kind of, even though he wasn't actually there, you can just feel that like he is actually there. It is really sad that he's no longer with us, but eventually we all have to move on. So, straight up the controls, use the right, use the left analog stick to move the character, use the right analog stick to move the camera. So, before we go off and chase Slimer, let's take a shower. Dang it. That ruined it. Oh well. Ah. A nice good hot shower while wearing electrical equipment. And this shower's apparently been gooped or slimed. As to why they never bothered to remove that slime, I will never know. Yeah, a few bits here. We have some sinks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, hey, I am the new cadet. And of course, we have the bedroom with 5 beds for each of the Ghostbusters. We got the lockers, some form of lockers up here. And now another thing that I actually, that's actually interesting. Here's actually some, a bit of an Easter egg. Here we have Cupid. Yeah, you can actually kind of interact with it, but it's like, but you don't actually get to play it though. Right here, I don't know what arcade this game is. Even if I were to look it up, future me would probably not even know much about it. So if anyone who knows about this game, oh hey, just let me know in the comments. Anyway, there's nothing else to do up here, so down we go. Whee! I'm got. Okay, no. He's. I guess until cutscene happens, then he'll talk. Also, I'm gonna be quiet for a bit and let you hear this.
Hello, Ghostbusters. Just one moment. Let me get a pen.
I see what? The evil. The
Slimer went that way.
When did this occur?
The glove won't fit.
I can schedule an appointment.
Another 1,000 failures, and I'll have enough negative energy to return to the world of
Thank
the living.
Thank you so much for calling.
I see the evil of the times to come. The glove won't fit.
The employee on a river of blood,
I will arrive. I see the evil of the times to come. 3 more faraway wars will come, and they will tarnish even the undisputed glory of the first 3.
Ghostbusters.
Oh, you're too busy, huh?
No. Not at the present time. Goodbye.
So, just about every single actor from the first 2 movies has made their return. Even this guy, who, future me, put the name in there please, returns from the 2nd movie, even though he's just here with a picture. So anyway, I'm gonna once again have to shut up again, because we're about to enter a cutscene.
Missing an opportunity.
There it is. It seems oddly drawn to the containment grid.
He's been fascinated with it ever since you added the viewer to the unit.
Okay, easy now, cadet. I'll talk you through this. Use the proton stream to get his attention.
So, looks like we're gonna have our first test of our proton stream. Just like any other shooter game, press the R2 button. So, let me tell you this right now. Even if you try your best not to hit that thing, it won't matter. See, Slimer is not reacting to it. Like, even if you just slightly tap it like this.
That's some highly sensitive equipment you're disintegrating there, kid. Oops, you left one out.
That's my fault. I was fine-tuning the interspatial gasket this afternoon. I'll fix it. You two get those ghosts back.
Oh boy, that's gonna be a difficult part of this let's play. Me trying to be quiet when they're talking while not in the cutscene. That's gonna be fun to deal with. So anyway, before we go off and go after Slimer, that big fat one, here's another thing about this game. Oh, so they're not... I did not know about that part. Okay, so it's not gonna be shown yet then.
Since you're already strapped into a pack, it's a perfect opportunity for some training.
taking the right. Ooh, we got a little hint as to future tech.
Okay, let's go get him. Oh, and don't sweat the containment. It's easy to get excited your first time out with the proton stream. Egon will fix it in no time. Now, first and foremost, before things get out of hand, you want to get to know your proton pack. It can be your best friend out there in the field. Everything you need to know is displayed on the pack itself. Here's where you keep an eye on your current physical condition. The more green that's on the bar, the more damage you can sustain and still stay on your feet. This bar indicates your pack's heat level. When it gets to the top, you'll want to vent the pack and keep it from shorting out and resetting. For the most part, capturing a ghost is pretty straightforward. We break it into three basic steps. Sap them, cap them, and trap them. The first step is blasting a ghost to sap its energy.
So, like he said there, the first thing you want to, like I said, mention, pressing R2, we'll release the proton stream. And as you kind of see right there, the ghost, those blue bars right there that are in green are the ghost health. The less damage they have, I mean, the more damage they take, the lesser that health is, you can just start instantly capturing them. And like he said, we're going to re-show this again. The more you use your proton stream, the more you're going to have to eventually... Oh, wow, now they start showing that little thing. Until you've got this one locked. The more that you're going to have to basically press the R2 button to basically reload. And as he said, with the green bar on the proton pack is your health. Per usual, like any other game, once you're out of health, it's instant game over. Anyway, let's go have some fun with Slimer.
Accumulation of a ghost PKE. The more you disperse, the weaker it becomes.
Yep, I kind of just basically said that. He did for me. So as you kind of see there, while trying to hit Slimer, our stream, proton stream, is going out of control and everywhere. Ooh! Ooh! And yes, ghosts will damage you. Also, if anyone's going to ask me why I have not mentioned anything about money yet, it's because I want to wait until we get more into that. Oh, he missed.
There it is! Ugh, and I thought Slimer was disgusting.
Yep. So this one, now there's actually a few different types of ghosts. Some can do long range, and some of them can do close range. This one here can do long range attacks. Slimer, as an example, he can do, I think he can do like both long and close range, but I think he mainly does close range attacks when he charges at you. Kind of like what he did to Peter during the first Ghostbuster movie. I wonder if it's going to happen again.
Next stage, cap. You can project the capture stream or wrangler manually using this control. On the other hand, the pack will detect when a ghost is sufficiently weakened and auto-select the capture stream setting. Get in there and throw a capture stream on that tub of goo.
Man, our proton streamer stream's just going all over the place.
Give it a shot! That's it! Perfecto! How do you like that, two-tone pork belly? A couple of good slams will take the fight out of just about any end. Slam it! Play rough, kid. I love it. Now we can move to stage three. Trap him. You're gonna need some place to put that.
So, the next... Yeah, I know, I know the characters are gonna explain to you, but hey, I don't wanna miss any part of that. So, like he said right there, during earlier, he was talking about the slam mechanic. Basically, not only will the ghost be taking a bit more damage. Oh wait, can they actually recover some of that HP? Oh wow, they can actually recover a bit of their HP. Huh. Learn something every day. Nope. So once again, the slam is just basically to help it make it a little more easier to control.
Perfect. See the beacon signal coming from the closed trap? That helps you find. Whatever you do, keep him in that trap zone. Very nice, kiddo. You've got some real promise. Oh, and always remember to retrieve your trap.
Did you get them?
We're batting 500. Slimer slipped out. Our cadet bagged his first one, though. Very nasty customer. Oh, and you've got to be very careful about crossing the streams. In a word, don't do it.
Seriously.
Stings like the Dickens, too.
Hey, how come this mump gets all the new stuff?
He's our new experimental equipment technician.
He gets a cool title, too?
It means he gets to carry around a bunch of untested, extremely dangerous hardware that, if not handled correctly, could blow him somewhere into New Jersey.
Oh, this knucklehead lugs around our very dangerous prototype hardware that could potentially blow us into New Jersey. Thanks. Keep the title, kid. It'll work hard for you.
Scooter, we need to go. Let's roll.
Okay, I'm back. So, yep, we have our basics down. While straight up, we haven't gone through everything, we at least know the controls, what to do, what our objectives are. Of course, obviously enough, our objective is to capture ghosts to move forward through the story. Now I want to see, can I do this? Can I show this off yet? Okay, yes, I actually can. They're going to explain this eventually, but I'm just going to do this right now. So, there are two things you want to know. First thing is, straight up, you want to collect money. How do you get money? You trap ghosts. That's how you earn money. Now, here's another thing you should know about money. Whatever you do, even if you want to do as badly as possible, try your best to not destroy the environment. The game actually punishes you if you were to break or destroy the environment. So, you kind of actually saw it earlier. If you looked on the top left of the screen, during while I was fighting Slimer and that fat ghost, or sloth ghost, he is ugly. You probably noticed I was breaking things, and by breaking the things, I was losing money. Money is going to be your biggest role in the game. It's going to help you get some stuff. Of course, right now all I only have is $2,000. All I had was $200. Kind of wish the game kind of start you off with $20,000, so that way you could probably. Then again, I think that'll be a little make the that a little too easy, like, oh hey, do you want the bigger options, or do you want the smaller options? So yep, as we move further in the game, we get some more upgrades and more stuff to buy. But that's not until we move on from another level, or until we get new equipment. Another thing right here is artifacts. I can't really explain what artifacts are because we haven't collected anything. Here we have training. This will just basically you want to learn. So right here, well, most of the time the game will, we will eventually get to some of this stuff. Okay, this is something the game actually doesn't tell you that I can tell you at least. Teammate revival. If you or a teammate is down, and if you're not alone, a teammate will revive you from any of the four original Ghostbusters. If you're the lone wolf and you die, it's a game over. Completely by yourself, it's a game over. It doesn't matter. I think, yeah, it's just really, that's about it. Okay, so another thing I'm going to mention about ghost trapping. So, as you kind of saw, I was playing a little war with the ghost by tugging it back and forth, back and forth. You need to keep the ghost in the middle, or at least on the sides. If the ghost gets away from the trapper, it will instantly reset, and you will have to do it again. And I think that's about it, actually, yeah. There's nothing else to talk about. So, that's going to be it for today's episode. If you enjoyed today's episode, please share, like, subscribe if you want to. And we're going to be going forth to the hotel. I'll see you all then.